Hi, I'm Guru from IT for Change. IT for Change is an NGO in Bangalore, India that works in the area of technology and social change. I work in the area of technology and education, and today I'll be talking to you about how ICT policy and program design and implementation connects to school level implementation of technology programs in education. I would like to explore this along two paradigms. In the first paradigm, which is what was prevalent for most of the last decade and the thinking is still alive now as well, is to see ICT as a specialized area which requires experts who may not be from the school education domain. So in the last decade, we have seen large technology vendors champion themselves as education experts and attempt to design and implement technology programs in education. The initial program design of the Government of India MHRD also supported this by suggesting that technology programs are best implemented using what is called the boot model, wherein the vendor was asked to build, own, operate and then transfer the infrastructure and the program to the school education at the end of a specified period. Under this boot thinking, the regular school teachers are not considered capable or interested in transacting technology in the school, in the classroom processes. So the vendor provides their own syllabus, the vendor sends their own faculty, who's typically a computer science or a BCA and not a BEd or a diploma in education qualified person, to transact the curriculum. The curriculum itself is usually based on, you know, office applications like Microsoft Office, which is proprietary software, and pre-packaged content created by these companies. The content and software are both proprietary, meaning that the school doesn't own it, the school system doesn't own it, it's actually owned by the vendor and licensed to the school. Under this paradigm, the school and the teachers usually see the ICT program as a standalone item which has no connection to what they do. The HMs don't own the program, nor do they own the lab which is owned by the vendor until the transfer happens. And over the program period, you find that it is a standalone program which it doesn't connect, and therefore at the end of the boot period, there is no meaningful continuation of the program and the computer lab degenerates into a computer museum. By and large, this is the state of the computer programs in India across the country, and the boot model inevitably leads to computer museums because it is not owned by the school and it is not seen as a regular curricular process. This is what we have seen in India across most states, but Kerala designed the program differently. It did not adopt the boot model. In Kerala, technology has been seen as an important component of the school's own resources and processes. What I will now describe as paradigm 2 is not necessarily going to be restricted to what Kerala has done, but encompasses a lot of what IT for Change has done over the last few years. In this paradigm, technology is seen as a very important resource that the school and the teacher has. It's important because the main aspects of teaching learning, content and pedagogy, are both transformed by technology. The world of content, hitherto we used to say, talk about textbooks. Textbook is typically the be and all for many teachers. The word text itself suggests the nature of the material. But technology, digital technologies allow materials to be available in different ways, as animations, as videos, as audio podcasts, as web resources, and in different formats. These are only formats, but in these different formats, teachers can create materials, teachers can access materials, teachers can revise and edit content made by others in different ways. Technology also alters pedagogy. The chalk and talk as a method is now complemented and supplemented by so many different ways of teaching using videos and using any of these digital resources that I described just now. In fact, this is how the whole idea of TPCK or TPAC has come about. The idea that the teacher's own knowledge is now influenced by the technology knowledge, the pedagogy knowledge and the content knowledge the teacher has got, and each of these impacts the other two. So in this model, which is what IT for Change has been working on for the last several years in Karnataka from 2011, and now also in states like Telangana or Assam or Andhra Pradesh, we strongly support a program design in which technology is seen by the education system and by the school as another resource, although very important, teachers' capacities are built to understand technology in different ways, not simply as users of select software applications, but to be digital literate, to be aware of hardware, software in various dimensions, multiple applications, different methods of creating materials, different methods of teaching using technologies. Our program design strongly emphasizes that teachers should actually make materials in different forms. Not that this material is necessarily of high quality and can be used by all teachers, but that the very process of material making using digital technologies actually has a huge impact on teachers' own understanding of materials, understanding of the role materials plays in the teaching learning processes, and actually makes them amenable and open to looking at content available in different forms from made by different other people. We strongly support the use of technology for supporting professional learning communities of teachers, where teachers network and support one another to support lifelong learning, and where teacher education is not limited to point-in-time workshops, but where continuous mentoring peer learning happens over virtual forums throughout the year. This is not theory, this is what IT for Change has implemented through the Subject Teacher Forum program and the Karnataka Open Education Resources program in Karnataka for 5 years from 2011 to 16, and is working on the Telangana repository of OER and the Telangana Subject Teacher Forums now to look at a different paradigm. Now to connect back to policy, I talked about practice. So initially when India began ICT policy making in the early parts of last decade, the initial policy making group had technology vendors, large vendors, I don't need to take their names, but they probably were the largest software company at that time, the largest hardware company at that time, the largest training company in India. And they came together pretty much to make a policy which did not have much connect to education policies, education priorities, context and needs. And IT for Change and many other educationists worked together to convince the government that that was not the right way to go. And subsequently in 2012, NCRT, which was tasked with the mandate, released a policy which is much more in line with educational policies, educational priorities and educational thinking. And this is the 2012 policy which teachers must definitely look at, which looks at technology in the various ways as I mentioned, as a support to teachers to expand their own world of learning. So in this way, policy has changed, and this new policy is now being support, which the new policy is now supporting similar program design in other states as well. One of the important parts which I didn't mention is the whole movement of the technology design from proprietary content, proprietary software, to a free and open technology environment. Kerala succeeded because it used only free and open source software. And in the world of content, we now talk about OER or open content. The combination of open software, open source, or what is called as FOSS, and open education resources is what enables technology to be really meaningful for education. And I think free and open is a non-negotiable for education. Anybody, any program that uses proprietary technologies is inimical to the interests of teachers and schools. And the proprietary nature of the technology is deeply corrosive of the public nature of education. I would like you to think about what I said, read the National Policy of Education, ICT Policy of 2012, the National ICT Curriculum that NCRT released in 2013, and study the whole progress of the policy making in India, which is available on our website, and enjoy this process. Thank you.